Hello, welcome to my channel. In this video we will discuss about data structure and algorithm. And in my previous videos I always talked about the important questions which came in exam previous question papers, but I have got a lot of query about the answer of that questions. So in this video or in this playlist we will discuss about the data structure and what is data structure and in analysis, and discuss the important questions which came in previous year's exam. So let's start. Before we start the questions, first we will discuss some important terms. Algorithm. What is algorithm? The word algorithm means a process or set of rules to be followed in calculation or other programming solving operations. If you are making any and pizza and all, and you have recipe, the number of steps which you followed. And in algorithm, before doing any programming, we have to do some number of operations, and step by step we are doing a programming or write any program. So therefore algorithm refers to a set of rule instructions step by step define how a work is to be executed upon in order to get the expected result. An algorithm is a well-defined procedure that allow a computer to solve a problem. A search engine uses algorithm. जो Google search engine है, it also uses a algorithm. Algorithm, what is algorithm? A number of steps. And analysis of algorithm. Why it is necessary to analyze algorithm? Algorithms, if you are writing any algorithm, the main thing is how much time required to perform the execution and how much space required to perform the execution of algorithm. These two things are very important, because when we are doing any algorithm, anything, you want to give minimum time for everything and minimum space. In the programming, if you are writing any algorithm, the time complexity and space complexity are the two terms which are necessary for analysis of any algorithm. Why it is necessary to analyze any algorithm? If for the productivity, what you want? Ki in minimum time we finish maximum work, or with less memory of computer we can perform any program? In business, what you do? You want to get more profits in minimum efforts. And same in programming. When we are writing any algorithm, then we analyze the algorithm, time complexity, and in the terms of we analyze algorithm in terms of time and space. Time complexity is very important as compared to space complexity. It depends upon the situation. For example, if we are cooking pizza or you are writing a recipe, okay, so here the algorithm of pizza, time needed to cook pizza, how much time needed to cook a pizza and space needed to store a pizza. It's a time complexity and it's a space complexity. So you can understand with the example of pizza, because everyone likes pizza. So let's discuss about the very important question which came in previous year exam questions. So now you can understand the time complexity and space complexity. So the definition here is very easy definition. Total time required by an algorithm to complete its execution is called time complexity. We denote with total time with TN. Okay, N is an input. And in space complexity, the total memory or space required by an algorithm to complete its execution. So we denote it with S and N is input. So let's come to the question. Define the time complexity and space complexity. Now you can understand with this example, what is time complexity and space complexity. So let's see the detail, because in exam we we have to write for 10 marks or 20 marks. So detail is very important. So here is the definition. Every algorithm requires some amount of time, the same definition. And generally the running time of algorithm depends on the following factors. What type of processor you are using, single processor or multiprocessor, and what type of machine you are using, 32-bit or 64-bit, or speed, what is the speed of machine in read and write, or the amount of time required by an algorithm to perform arithmetic operation and logic operation and return value. When we calculate time complexity of an algorithm, we consider only a input data and ignore the remaining thing like machine dependent. Okay, so we are only focusing here on the input value. Calculating the time complexity of an algorithm based on the system configuration is very difficult task because the configuration changes from one system to another. To solve this problem, we assume the model machine with a specific configuration so that we can able to calculate generalized time complexity. So here is we assume that our machine model is single processor, 32-bit, perform sequential execution, and time required, unit of time at the operation is 1 unit, and time of assignment and return value. It requires 1 unit of time for read and write operation. Now we calculate the time complexity of the following example, and you can better understand with this example, and here is a code. So in the above sample code, it requires 1 unit of time to calculate A plus B. To return the value, that means totally it takes 2 units of time to complete this execution, and it does not change based on the input value of A and B. That means for all input require the same amount of time, and this if any program requires a fixed amount of time for all input value, or if you are it's not changing, then it's called a constant time complexity. So time complexity is of two type: constant time complexity and linear time complexity. Now here is an example of linear time complexity. Here is a piece of code, and here is a calculation of time complexity, cost, repetition, total. So here is a one time required for line is 1 unit and repetition 1, and total time is 1, and by the sum of these three ones here and this, 2n plus 2 is the total time, and for this step 2 and return sum. So the calculation, the total time of required is 4n plus 4 for this piece of code. So let's come to first in cost is the amount of computer time. The calculation of cost, the amount of computer time repetitions, the amount of time required by each operation for each repetition. The total amount is 4n plus 4. Totally, it takes 4n plus 4 units of time to complete the execution, and it is called a linear time. The definition is that the amount of time required by algorithm is increased with the increase of input. Jaise hum increase karte jaate hain input, to ye time bhi required for algorithm bhi increase hota hai. So this is called linear time complexity. Now come to space complexity. When we design an algorithm to solve a problem, we need some computer memory to complete its execution. For any algorithm, memory is required for the following purposes: to store program instruction, to store constant value which does not change, and to store writer value. A few other things like function call, jumping statement, etc. Space complexity can be defined if we think about the definition is the total amount of computer required by computer memory or space required by an algorithm to complete is called space complexity of the algorithm. And generally when a program is under execution, it uses computer memory for three reasons: instruction space, environmental space, stack, and data space. So data space, it is the amount of memory used to store all the variable and constant. So in space complexity, we basically use data space. When you want to perform analysis of algorithm based on space complexity, we consider only data space or include instruction and environmental stack. Calculate the space complexity, we must know the memory required to store the different data values according to the compiler. For example, in C programming language. Compiler requires 2 bytes for integer, float for floats it's 4 bytes, whole point value, 1 byte true character value and 6, and 8 byte to true double value. As example, so you can better understand with this example of piece of code. Here it requires, in the above, two bytes require for variable A, store variable, and another 2 bytes required to return a value. That means total required 4 bytes of memory, its execution, 4 bytes of memory is fixed for an input value. This space complexity is set to constant space complexity. Similar like time complexity, space complexity is of two type, fixed time, fixed space, constant space complexity and linear. So if an algorithm requires fixed amount of space, all input value, whatever input we use, a fixed amount of space, then the space complexity is called constant space. So here is the next example, you can see here. In the above piece of code, it requires n into 2 bytes of memory to store value, variable A, and 2 bytes of memory integer parameter n, and 4 bytes local variable I, 2 bytes each. So that means total time required is 2n plus bytes of memory to complete the execution. Here the total amount of memory required to depend on the value of n. As value increases, the space required also increases proportionally. So this time of space complexity is said to be linear space complexity. So you can see definition here. Now come to the second part of question. What are the differences between them? So in time complexity, main focus is time, and in space complexity, memory or space is main. So if we want our program to run fast or a minimum time, so here is the time complexity is important. If we don't worry about the time and we need less space or less memory to run a program, so space complexity is important. It depends on you, what you want, what is your preference. So let's discuss with these examples here. Basically, everyone wants to finish their program or execution fast, so time complexity is more important. So, and you can write in difference between, because what are the factors and what are the types of complexity, and the purposes, the purpose of space is to store program instruction, constant variable value and function calls. But in time complexity, their purpose is perform operations in minimum time. Or depends on the following factor, and it's of two types, constant time and linear time. And okay, so now this question is, and in our next video we will discuss about another important question. So if you like my video, please press like button and subscribe my channel if you don't subscribe now, and you can see more videos on my YouTube channel. They are helpful for you for your exam. Assembly language, C, financial accounting, computer networking. These are the playlist, and you can see, and whatever video you like, you can see here. The topic you like, advanced data and web development. In web development, there is HTML, JavaScript playlist. Here is a core Java and artificial intelligence. You can see and explore the. It is a pleasure.
Welcome to my channel, and here is a new video, and it's about Java and Java, core Java. So let's start. And in previous videos, I discussed about the important questions.